what have been some of your favorite moments on the stage?
Wow. So hard to compare, but if I start from my early career, then like 88, I just started the US career, and I did some few opening acts, right? And then that was California dates, and few cities I did special guests for Miles Davis. So Poster has a special guest, Miles Davis, special guest Keiko Matsui. That was like, wow.
That's pretty great. Yeah.
And my band member was like excited, and then I was at the backstage, and somebody said like, Miles is coming, and then I was stood like this, and then he was just across from my dressing room, and he saw me, and I saw him, and I said hi, you know, Japanese bow, right? Japanese bow like this, hi, and he said hi. And his aura was great, and of course we, after our performance, we enjoyed his performance from the theater. We saw that, and also I did George Benson's special guest too. And then after 30 years later, we were on the same cruise, and I saw George, and hi George, hi Keiko, and oh, I'm so happy, and I'm proud of you. You are doing wow, and that was great. Reunite moment.
Yeah.
So that kind of thing happened when I started, and then gradually I start to doing my show as a headlining, because some part with different combination with the artists, I was told that you got too many standing ovation, even you are opening act. So I think that was a good thing. And then I start getting more headlining shows, and now I'm touring. And one special one, many special ones, but when I did first United Air Force Orchestra collaboration show at the Constitution Hall in DC, and yeah, that was quite moment. And that time my first album is called A Drop of Water, and theme song was sung by Carl Anderson, who is in the heaven already, but he came with me and with the United Air Force Orchestra at the Constitution Hall. It was free concert, and so many sold out audience were there, and we did a show as a guest, and that was pretty special. And when I did the first time concert in Johannesburg, South Africa, before going there, my manager told me, you will enjoy it, you are the star over there. So I said, no way, I never been there. Then I found that my PBS special video was aired by satellite and to European continent, and also Africa. So that's why without me going there, my music started working by music itself. So when I went to South Africa, that was like outside the festival, and so many audience there. And when I started playing, and I hear audiences singing. So my music is mostly instrumental, but why they are singing what I'm playing? Then I notice they are singing to my melodies with a humming, and sometimes that could put my name, Keiko Keiko. They call Kika. Keiko 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 Matsui, and they're singing to it. And that was quite a surprise, and very happy to find out. And sometimes Russia, and I studied the Russian tour around 2000. And of course, I never played there, but when I did first show at the beautiful opera house of type of place in Moscow, and the audience is like a vibe is like a classical concert, and ladies and gentlemen with a black tie, and even kids wear the tuxedo, and they were sitting quietly. And after first song, I finish and I bow and going to start talk. Then their clapping, applause didn't stop. Like brava, brava, bravo, brava, brava, and it became like this tempo. So this kind of thing happened at the end of the show usually, right? For Uncle. Mm-hmm. But that was the beginning of the show, and that was quite surprise, but a great moment.